open toric varieties. So.
Thank you. This is a with Megumi Harada and Mikiya Masuda. So the first content is apology. Apologize to Professor Masuda and Professor Harada because in my abstract, I forgot the word. This is a joint work with Megumi Harada and Mikiya Masuda. I'm very, very sorry. So I emphasize this phrase in the top page. Okay, I don't know about mass quantity. Background, Peterson variety, denoted PET, is a possibly singular variety, sub-variety of a flag variety. It is known that Peterson variety is associated to the quantum cohomology of the flag variety. So it is natural to study its topology. For example, the structure of its equivariant cohomology rings or ordinary cohomology rings. So our goal is to give an explicit presentation of the equivariant cohomology ring of Peterson variety. Okay. This is our goal. This is our goal. Okay. Our description of the ideal I uses the Carlton matrix and it's uniform across V types. On the other hand, the description of the equivariant cohomology rings of Peterson variety for V type A is given by Fukukawa, Harada, and Masuda. Our results generalize the result of Fukukawa, Harada, and Masuda, which was only for V type A. First, I explain the type A Peterson variety. Definition of type A Peterson variety. Let N be the nilpotent matrix of size N in the Jordan-Kernka form with one Jordan block. The Peterson variety is defined by
N plus N dimension of
the particle. That an element of flag variety V dot is a nested subspaces of Cn where dimension Vi equal to I. So that is an element of Peterson variety satisfy n times Vi is included in the next subspace Vi plus 1. Okay. This is the definition of type A Peterson variety. Let T be a diagonal matrix in general linear group. Then the T naturally acts on the flag variety. But the T does not preserve the Peterson variety in general. So we introduce a subtorus S which preserves the Peterson variety. S is defined by like this. Like this. This subtorus S is introduced by Harada and Timotsuko. Motivation is the following proposition. The subtorus S preserves the Peterson variety. So we consider the S equivariant cohomology ring of Peterson variety. The S equivariant cohomology ring of type A Peterson variety is isomorphic to the quotient of a polynomial ring by an ideal I. where H stands for where H stars point is identified with a polynomial ring with variable t, and I is an ideal generated by like this. Here we use the convention x0 equal xn equal to 0. That is, if I equal 1, this is x0 equal to 0, and if I equal n minus 1, this is xn equal to 0. Okay. We use this convention. We consider twice the generator of I. Yeah. Twice the generator of I is equal to like this, where bracket alpha I alpha j is the Cartan integer. Recall that type A n minus 1 Cartan matrix is like this. Diagonal is just 2 and minus 1. brackets I alpha just is ij component of this Cartan matrix. Okay. We notice this transformation. This transformation. Okay. Our results for all three types, we have this isomorphism, where I is an ideal generated by like this. So this is just the previous form, the right hand side. Okay. So from now on, I explain the Peterson variety for any real type. Notation: let G be a complex semi-simple linear algebraic group of rank n. So, for example, type an, Z equal special linear group of size n plus 1. Let B be a Borel subgroup of Z. For example, we can choose B equal upper triangular matrix is in special linear group. Let T be a maximal torus of Z. For example, we can choose T equal diagonal matrix in special linear group. These choices determine the following data: simple roots alpha 1, alpha 2, lambda alpha n, while group W, real algebra, and root spaces K alpha. So definition of Peterson variety in any real type. Let E alpha be a basis of a basis element of the root space K alpha. Recall that K alpha is a one-dimensional vector space. And let n be the sum of E alpha, where alpha is simple root. Okay. The Peterson variety is defined by like this. This mod B is flag variety, called flag variety. Anyway, we can define the Peterson variety in any real type. Okay. Next, I explain the subtorus S preserves the Peterson variety in any real type. We consider the homomorphism from T to sister N by sending T to alpha 1 T, alpha 2 T, alpha n T. as defined, alpha I is a simple root. That is, alpha is a homomorphism from T to C star. And define S as a connected component of the identity in phi inverse of diagonal element, scalar element. This subtorus S is introduced by Harada and Timotsuko. Okay.
The first case, you say that S is the diagonal by this manifold, right? G square, G power 3, right?
Yes.
The one-dimensional and torus in type A case.
Okay.
It's not the diagonal one, but the G square and G power 3.
So our setting is semi-simple linear algebraic group. Strictly, this is false, not one dimension.
So the
source
S is the maximal one, which
preserves the Peterson model. The motivation is the following proposition. The subtorus S preserves the Peterson model. So, main result. The equivariant cohomology ring of the Peterson variety in any D-type. Is isomorphic to the quotient of a polynomial ring by an ideal high, where H dice point is identified with QT and I is an ideal generated by like this. So this presentation is uniform across three types. The odd degree cohomology group of Peterson variety vanish. So we have an explicit presentation of ordinary cohomology ring of Peterson variety by taking t equal to 0. So just this. We have this corollary. Since the odd degree cohomology group of vanish, the forgetful map, okay.
Why? How do you know that the odd degree
So we have this covariant. Yeah. I think the generator of I is simple. Okay. Now I talk about sketch of proof. First, we consider the projection, which is induced from inclusions of groups. We consider this projection. And the image of Schubert class, this is Schubert class. Indexed by an element of Y group. The image of Schubert class under the projection map row is called Peterson Schubert class and denoted by PW. We use two facts. First, this projection map is surjective. Second, the Schubert classes sigma si generates this ring as a static point algebra. Here, SI is a simple reflection with respect to the simple root alpha I. For example, type AN, SI is the transposition of I in I plus 1. From the two facts, we see that the Peterson-Schubert class is PSI generates H star S bed as H star S point algebra. PSI generate H star space as H star point algebra. We identify with one polynomial ring with one variable. First, we prove that the first claim is we prove that the PSI satisfies this relation using Monk formula and Jambelli formula. Okay, first claim. We prove this relation. So now I explain Monk formula and Jambelli formula. To explain this formula, I need a few preliminary. For subset K of simple roots, with subscript A1HAK strictly increasing. We define VK by this equation. The Peterson-Schubert class is PVK. VK is the above element of our group. Form a QT module basis for H size pet. So we can write PSI times PVK can be written as QT linear combination of PVJ, where J is subset of simple roots. Monk formula is to give explicitly the coefficient CIKJ explicitly. That is this theorem. PSI times PVK can be written as explicitly QD linear combination of PVJ. CIKJ is non-negative rational number and explicitly can be written as like this. Here, WJ or WK means fixed points, S fixed points of Peterson variety. And PV of WK is a value of localized at fixed point WK. PSI times PVK can be written explicitly as QT linear combination of PVJ. Next, I explain Jambelli formula. Recall that the Peterson Schubert class is PSI generates H style PET as QT algebra. So we can write PVK can be written as some polynomial F with QT coefficient. Jambelli formula is to give explicitly the polynomial F. Explicitly. That is this way. Assume that the Dynkin diagram corresponding to the subset K of simple roots is connected. For example, K equal alpha I plus 1 is connected for type AN. Alpha 1, alpha 2 is connected. Then we have the following equation. Okay. So PVK can be written as a monomial with invariable PS1 rather than PSN. This is just monomial. VK bar denotes the number of distinct reduced word expression for VK. Okay. Using Monk formula and Jambelli formula, we prove the first claim. Applying Monk formula to K equal to alpha I, namely VK equal SI. So K equal to alpha I, just VK equal SI. Then the left hand side is just PSI square. Okay. PSI square. And which is that, which is that psi of W alpha I is just T by calculating, okay, just T, okay. And the second term become this form. On the other hand, applying Jumbery formula to k called alpha j alpha I, namely pk called sj si, we have this equation. Recall that Jumbery formula, this k is alpha I alpha j, so this is just one, because alpha I alpha j is connected, so si and sj don't commute. So this is vk is only one reduced word expressions, that is vk is sj si. And this number is just 2. So we have this equation. We substitute this equation for twice of this relation. Twice both sides. So twice. And twice of PSJ SI is equal to just PSI times PSJ. So we have this relation. From bracket alpha I, alpha I is always equal to 2. So this is just bracket alpha I, alpha I. So we have the first claim. We have the desired equation. So we have a surjective ring homomorphism from this ring to the equivariant cohomology ring, sending xi to psi. Xi to psi, where I is ideally generated by like this. This is well defined. Finally, we compare Hilbert series of both sides. So we see that this map is isomorphism. So the proof is complete. I stop here. Thank you very much.